when you have a suicide attempt, they're obviously in a life crisis. Society dictates, understandably, that the priority be given to them. But what happens, I think, is that the partner's lived experience is lost in that. The book is written primarily for partners and mental health professionals, but it's also for significant others like parents, siblings, and friends. It aims to provide sustenance, therapy, and meaning to partners. It's a way of telling partners that we hear you, that we see you, and that your thoughts and feelings are absolutely valid. And that applies to those feelings of care and compassion, as well as the shadow feelings of trauma, anguish, hurt, and betrayal. Virtually no partners turn up in psychotherapy, so this book gives voice to partners for the first time and provides some stepping stones to recovery. Partners being viewed solely as caregivers or guardians tells only half the story. So the book shifts the focus of the conversation to include partners, and it charts for the first time through direct accounts from partners the traumatic freefall they experience. For the first time, I think I'm suggesting that partners are invited to the table and join the conversation. Historically, they joined the conversation as informants, but this is the first time now that they are being asked to join the conversation as a person in their own right.